All right, we've done so much. We've calculated the size of the Earth and the Moon and the distance from the Earth to the Moon. Might as well figure out the distance to the Sun as well, right? Let's look at a picture. Here's the Earth, here's the Moon. Over here, we have the Sun. Now let me say again, this is not to scale. The Sun should be much larger and much further away than depicted here. The Moon should be further away as well. Now, the picture I've drawn here is a very special alignment of the Earth, Moon, and Sun. This is what's called a half moon. The reason why is the Sun is striking the Moon, and based on this geometry, it can only strike this side of the Moon. Well, it's always only striking half of the Moon. What makes this so special? Well, what's special is from Earth, if we look up, we just see everything on this side of this blue line, everything below this blue line. And as you can see, everything to the left of this dividing line is in the light, and everything on the other side, to the right, is not. So to us, this actually appears like a half moon. Even though the Moon is always only half illuminated, this is the one special geometry where we only see half of the visible side illuminated to us. So we've got this special geometry that happens about twice a month. And what makes it special? You can maybe guess that we can draw a right triangle between the Earth, the Sun, and the Moon. In the previous problem, you calculated this distance. And I'm not going to tell you exactly what we calculated, but let's say it's very close to 400,000 kilometers. That's the distance from the Earth to the Moon. Now, we can actually measure this angle. You've probably seen those strange days where the Sun and the Moon are both in the sky. I know this seems weird. The Moon's supposed to be out at night, Sun in the day, but hey, it happens like this sometimes. When it does happen like this, and it happens to be a half moon, we can measure this angle, and then, well, I think you see where we're going. We can measure this distance, L. This actually turns out to be a really, really large angle. So this angle, which I'll call alpha, alpha is actually equal to 89.853 degrees. So given this number and this distance between the Earth and the Moon, can you tell me what this L is, the distance between the Sun and the Earth? Give your answer in kilometers,